70-66. You advanced to play of the weekend by knocking off KCU third time in four meetings this year. You've really had their number. Your thoughts on that win yesterday?
It's good. It's a good win. I was kind of hoping to play somebody else. But anytime you can play your rival team that many times to come out with three wins, it's hard to beat anybody three times in a year. So I was pleased with our performance. We got a little slow, got a little tired towards the end because we played really well first half. I thought we played pretty well at the beginning of the second. But I'm pleased, though.
Opportunity now to potentially finish your season with a win. Not many people that go to the postseason can say that. How valuable could it be to finish with a W today, get to 19-19 on the year, and build some momentum or keep the momentum for next season?
Oh, it's great because anytime you can get a W at the end, these young guys, when you bring up the young guys, I got a bunch of sophomores who are really trying to figure out their role on this team, and when they get a chance to even be here and recognize what it's going to take to win a national championship, if we can get another win out of this, that just gives us our momentum as we get into the postseason here and start working out in a couple weeks and get ready for a new season. So it's a big deal.
Number three, North Central, the opponent today, reminds me of your squad just a little bit, just because there's so many weapons. Four guys in double digits. The hub of all that is Nathan Roeder, first-team All-American, 20 points, 5 assists. What makes him so special?
Well, when I watched him last night as I was scouting him, I thought, man, alive, this is us. We're going to be playing against each other. So, you know, when I went into our team meeting last night, I was going down through their personnel, talking about all their different weapons and the way they play. And honestly, it's kind of playing us. And so it'll be interesting how we dig in and play a team that does a lot of similar things. This team gets out on the secondary break, I would say second to us, but pretty good.
Sure.
Not too many teams this year had a really good secondary break, but this team gets out quick, and they try to get easy baskets on you. They have a pretty good post presence. They work real hard to seal. But I think the biggest thing is they got a couple guards that are just absolutely tenacious to get to the front of the rim. And they're the Energizer Bunnies. They just don't stop. They keep going and going and going. So it'll be interesting. We'll see what four games in 5 days looks like today.
What approach do you take to this game? Some coaches will empty the bench, you know, give the seniors, you've only got two, and they play considerable minutes anyway, but some coaches get all their seniors in and give them minutes. Some coaches play to win. What are you doing this one?
I'm playing to win. I got young guys on the bench. They'll get their chance. I don't worry so much about that. If there's opportunity to play some of them, you know, I'll take advantage of that. But I don't want to stop coaching. I like coaching all the way down to the end. And so I'm looking to try to win. I'll recognize my seniors and try to, you know, get them good playing minutes. And then at the end of the game, you know, give them the honors that they're deserved. Got a couple good ones. And both Tim and Mike, probably the poster kids for the NCCAA, both two-time scholar athletes. Tim, second-team All-American, have been in the program for 4 years. Have just done all the right things that you need in your players. And so real proud of them.
Coach, final game of the year, regardless of the outcome today, you don't win and continue. This is it. As you look back on this season and this squad, what are some memories, some things you're going to remember about 2010-2011?
This is probably the most consistent season we've ever had. We've had a couple really good years. Even last year we had 28-7, 28-8, something like that for the season. But only one game this year did we just completely blow it. I mean, we went down to Davenport up in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and we're not focused. We didn't have our act together. People weren't on the same page, and we really blew that game. But other than that game, this team, they battled every single game, and we had opportunities to close and win almost every game this year. You know, we went to Grace and played them really well. Down the stretch, missed a couple bunnies, gave up some layups at the very end there. We lost a buzzer beater to start the year against IU East that we played really, really well. Of course, we meet Mount Vernon early. He's played Cedarville this year. 2 minutes to go, it was a one-point game with Cedarville. I mean, I could go on and on and on, but this was probably the most consistent play we've ever had in all the years I've been coaching. And so I was real proud of this team. I feel like I feel like we're getting to that next level of consistent play. And I've had 4 years to really figure out a system that allows me to be versatile. So many coaches have one system, and they run that system to death no matter what kind of players they have. And I think in the last 4 years, I've really had the opportunity to develop a couple different offensive strategies and defensive strategies that allow me to work within the team that I have and within the squads that we're going to be playing each year. And so this team was a smart team this year and executed probably better than anybody I've had so far.
Coach, appreciate your time as always. I want to say on a personal note, thanks for letting me be a part of OCU basketball this year. The privilege was mine. Enjoyed working with you and a great bunch of guys. Thanks for the opportunity.
Rick, I appreciate it. We appreciate you, too. We've fallen in love with your program, and I know we got a lot of people out there enjoy having you do this for us. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Coach. That's Curtis Christopher here on the Rose Brothers Paving pregame show. Activity Center. It is a final. Curtis Christopher will join us momentarily. 84-71. And that was the Baker down. We were looking for a shot a moment ago, praying with both teams at center court after the game. And that's a cool situation. A dad praying for his two senior sons playing their last game, as well as both of these teams. Appreciate the Baker family, what they've meant to the OCU Athletic Department. And again, a shout out to Luke Furr, Ross Johnson, Levi Koistra, and the rest of the Trailblazers, or the rest of the Rams. Our OCU player of the game, come here right now, come on. Our OCU player of the game is Terrell Cumberland. Terrell Cumberland, our Citizens Bank of Asheville player of the game. Thought he was going to come talk to us. And now maybe he's going to come. He's one of those guys that's been begging for an interview the entire year. And when I give him the opportunity, that's okay. Put on a headset real quick, Terrell. First of all, congrats on the win. Player of the game, your thoughts on this win and what it might mean to this program to end 2011 with a victory.
It was good to end on a win. We lost on, what was that, Thursday. And, you know, we was down about it for a little bit, but it was good to get two wins and go out 3-1. And hopefully we can start strong next year.
How are you feeling right now? Thursday was a rough day, not only the loss, but a tough day for you personally. Ill all day Wednesday, didn't even get to make the banquet where they named you a first-team All-American. How frustrating is that to look back on a game where you guys had an opportunity, trailing by one at the intermission, and you're not able to help your team at full strength?
It was frustrating. I just had to sit there and watch pretty much. I mean, I got in there a couple of times and really couldn't do much, but it happens.
Thoughts on playing with Tim and Michael Baker? Final games for them. You've only had the privilege of a season with them, but big loss. I imagine both on and off the court.
Yeah, they're both leaders on and off the court, and it was fun playing with them. They're both good players, especially Tim shooting outside. I had someone else to shoot outside with me, and it was fun. We're going to miss them.
Let's talk about next year real quick. The cover definitely not bare. You're coming back for a senior season. Jeremy Hayes, Mike Farrell, potentially Byers and Knighton, potentially rejoining the team next year. Your thoughts on 2011-2012?
We're going to be strong if we can get everybody to come back. I think we can make a run at national championship easy. But that's just if everybody comes back and everything goes as planned. But, you know, who knows? But I think we have a strong season next year.
Terrell, it's been fun watching you play this year. The quickest, released in this tournament is how I describe you. Thanks for coming and talking to us. Appreciated watching you this year. We'll do it again next season.
Thanks.
That's Terrell Cumberland from Ohio Christian. He is the OCU Player of the Game, brought to you by the Citizens Bank of Asheville. They can get you where you're going. Inquire today about auto loan financing, new or used vehicles. Curtis Christopher, I'll give you a quick question or two. Absolutely. You can even put a headset on real quick here. Citizens Bank of Asheville, they're the sponsor of our Player of the Game. And Coach, do this real quick here. First of all, congrats on the win. Trailing by two after 20 minutes, what'd you do differently in the second half?
Just kept going. I tried to keep some fresh legs on the floor. Rotated a whole bunch of times there, and then just, you saw the last 10 minutes of the game, just kind of had to find five guys that had enough gas in the tank to get it done.
Absolutely.
And so we went 10 deep today, and just kind of worked on different guys to find out who still had some good legs, and got some shots to fall. Once we started the second half, I told the guys, you know, we don't need an outside shot to win this game, and so we started going post players, and then once we started doing that, the outside shot was even more open, and we got a couple to go and got that lead going, and we were able to sustain it. So
Mike Farrell, a big second half, he hit some big threes, and as you said, Jeremy Hayes really began to establish himself underneath the basket.
Yep. He's a strong boy. People don't realize just how strong he is. He's the only kid I've ever had to coach, a starting player who I have to tell to shoot the basketball.
Jeremy Hayes?
I have to tell him to shoot the basketball. I've just never had a kid like that before. Usually got to tell him, you know, take better shots or, you know, get a better look than that. But we have to tell Jeremy Hayes to put the ball on the floor and put it in the basket. And once he gets rolling, he's a strong kid.
There's a guy down in Grayson, Kentucky, I think, that knows how strong he is. That's had a tough four-game stretch against Mr. Hayes. I know I asked you this in the pregame. You lose Tim and Michael, but a lot coming back. Just a quick preview of 2011 and 12. A lot of people have heard about Byers and Knighton, what they brought to this team first semester. Do you expect them to come back? Do you expect the core of this OCU team to be back?
The core that you see here tonight are going to be back. You've got some young players just trying to earn their way right now and learn the system, get on the floor. You saw a couple of them this weekend. Josh Delph had a good weekend. You saw a little bit of Jay Allen. Jay Allen is a nice player, and
sure,
he will come along. He's a true freshman, and we're just going to keep working on him. Big James, he's going to be a junior next year. We've had 2 years under his belt, and every year he's getting a little bit better. And then as far as the other guys, we'll see how this all works out. Got a few nice recruits we've been working on as well, and so we plan on being back. I don't plan on having a letdown. I don't like to have a letdown, so we're going to work hard to keep it that way.
Neat opportunity here at the end. A lot of fans didn't digest what just happened, but Mr. Baker in the huddle, praying with both teams, praying over his two sons. I've not met Mr. Baker a whole heck of a lot, but looking at the fruit of his labor, he's got to be a special man.
This is a dad of seven kids, lives in a three-bedroom home, and has raised this family. I want to tell you what, they're a special family, real special family.
That was moving to see over here. Coach, thanks for coming by. Go celebrate with the guys, and hope to do it again in 2011, 2012.
All right, thank you.
That's head coach Curtis Christopher. An interview brought to you by Snyder Family Chiropractic. The Trailblazers, a winner. They do finish the season at 500, 19-19. North Central with the loss drops to 14-15. I want to say thanks to OCU. Thanks also to North Central for their support of our coverage. We'll take a final timeout, and Justin Glenn will get you ready for the next game here on the Christian College Sports Network.